And whether you like him or not, whether you like her or not, whether he's a nice guy or not, whether he's a bum or not, he's a bum that you picked to make two children with. Mm-hmm. And if he shows up to see the children on a Wednesday, and he's given you some indication that he wasn't going to be there on Wednesday, and for no other reason than he said he wasn't going to come, you don't let your children see him, that's wrong.
But is it?
That's wrong. It's not between the two of you. He could be the biggest bum in the world. He lived with his children. His children know who he is. They have a right to see their father unless he is abusive to them, dangerous to them, which I assume that prior to 2007, you never made that allegation. Would that be a fair statement?
That would be fair.
Well, then unless he had some psychotic breakdown, which I doubt.
Well,
no, which I doubt. Nothing changed with regard to his love for his children from 2007 to 2009, except that you were PO'd with him. Now, that's unfair. Whether you like that or not, it's unfair. It's unfair for the children. Unfair to him, I don't care about. Unfair to you, I don't care about. But it's unfair for the children. And if you deny them the right to see their father, they will eventually hate you. I want you to understand that. I want you to be prepared for the fact that if you don't let your children visit meaningfully with their father, there will be a day down the road when they will hate you. Justifiably so. Do you get it? Do you get it? Justifiably so. Because you will have allowed your anger to get in the way of their relationship with their father. Good, bad, or middle of the road. That's who you picked to make them with. You don't visit your bad judgment onto your children. Do we understand each other?
I understand you. I don't agree with you at all.
I don't give a... Listen, since I'm not adjudicating that or not, I have to tell you this. In 40 years, I've seen tens of thousands of women just like you mm-hmm. who will invest all of their beautiful bloom time in hating the person that they made their children with. And I guarantee you this. You know what's going to happen? Eventually, you're going to drive him away. He's got a beautiful new fiance, and he and this beautiful new fiance will go on and make a beautiful new family. And one day he's going to say, I'm tired. I want to see my kids. I would love to see my kids, and I feel badly that I'm not seeing my kids. But she really is an SOB, and she created this problem. And when they get older, they'll see me, but I'm not going to waste my time anymore. Eventually, he's going to say that.
Mr. Baxter said that.
Just a second. If he said it, it's because you made it difficult. I've seen you for a very short period of time. And I know that if he said it up until now, he said it because you've made it difficult. It's not right that he's got a new girlfriend, that he's gone on to a new life, that you don't have a new life, that you don't have a new life. All of those things are very unfair, that you're living with your sister, that you no longer have a home for your children. I read your answer.
We have a beautiful home. We have a beautiful new home, and we are very happy.
Well,
and we have
you want me to read your answer? You want me to read your answer?
Sure. Yeah.
Fine. I'm going to read what you said. Then if what you said is a lie, you said, because of Chris, I don't have a place to raise my children. My sister has taken us in on a temporary basis. That's what you swore to in your answer.
Yeah, but it's a beautiful home.
Ms. Rizzo, I said all that's necessary to you. Put your hand down. You have to know that this has nothing to do with you. You're extra. You're fodder. This has nothing to do with you. You have nothing to do with his children. You have nothing to do with his former life. This has nothing to do with you. Do you understand?
Yes, Your Honor.
Perfect. I wouldn't give up so easily on visiting with my children.
I don't plan on.
I wouldn't give up so easily. But I'm telling you, I did my best.